access data. Like that, it is a vast content. As usual, we are keep this as a psychological approach, not as spiritual approach. If we went for spiritual approach, there is so much of, for every petal, for every flower, for every petal, there is a bija mantra. As we are saying, only one mantra for one chakra, but there are so many mantras, bija mantras for every petal. For example, if there is a root chakra for only four petals, for four petals, there are again four bija mantras are there, but we are saying only one lam mantra. It is a superb content, and today we are going to discuss all. If you have any doubts, you can arise. So this Sunday, we discussed like that. Welcome, Mani. Happy morning.
Happy morning, Lavanya. Good.
Okay. Happy morning, sir.
Happy morning. So, ready for the reflection discussion.
Happy morning.
Happy morning, sir. Happy morning.
Morning. Brain is not working.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello, Anya.
And I said that today we discuss for all these.
Yes.
Because by showing mudras, especially with video.
Yes.
Every day we are just doing meditation. That's.
Yeah. So the first thing what I wanted to share you is the reason why we brought this chakra healing meditation. So we all know that meditation. So meditation is nothing but dhyana. So it is to control our mind. So in a proper posture. So when you say dhyanam posture, so we can have three different types of postures. One is sukhasana, sitting posture. So dhyanam can be done in only sitting posture. Remember, that is the only thing. So when you are sitting, in a straight, so where your spinal should be, the backbone should be very straight. From the bottom to the top, it should be in a single line. So that is the proper way of sitting posture. So that sitting posture, I have three different types. One is sukhasana. So sukhasana means, so when your two palms, the palm, so remember it's a palm. So remember, what if it's a feet? So when your two feet are on the floor, crossed on the floor, this is called sukhasana. When you say half padmasana, when one of your feet is on the floor and another feet is crossed on your lap, so it is on your lap, another lap. When you say lotus pose, okay, so sitting posture, lotus posture, both your feet are crossed on your laps. It's like this. Yeah, remember, this is like a lap. If this is a lap, this is a full lotus posture. This is a half lotus posture. Either this thing or this thing. So either of the side. Okay. And both the sides, if both are at the down, so this is a normal sukhasana. So this is the place. So before sitting for any meditation, I was mentioning the same thing everywhere. Try to find out the energy zone in your home. Okay. So all the meditations are energy generating exercises. Okay, we are going to generate the positive vibes. So we feel that, okay, sitting in a normal position and doing some, breathing exercise, that is what the meditation. No, meditation is complete. With the complete awareness, we are controlling our thoughts, emotions, feelings. Bring all together to control our mind, to generate the power. To control all those things, we need to put lot of energy, lot of force. By putting that energy, we are doubling the energy. We are releasing the huge energy from our brain, from our Brahmarandra. So this Brahmarandra, again, we don't want to get into the cosmic. Cosmic is nothing but an open energy, cosmic energy from the sun. So we want to bring that energy to be circulated around us. So that is how we are making the energy zone around us, so that you prepare a specific zone. Call it as an energy zone. Daily sit in the same place and practice your meditation in the same place, so that your zone will be more vibrated. Whenever you feel dull, whenever you feel depressed, whenever you feel not focused or not concentrated, go and sit into that energy zone. Even though if you come out of your energy zone, your soul, your replica would be there in that energy zone. That entire, in IPL, they call it as bio bubble, right? The same thing. This is called an energy bubble. We are creating this energy bubble. When you sit in the same place, in the same way, and practicing the same thing on a daily basis. So, are you clear about this energy bubble? Is there any doubts? This is called, we call it as energy zone. Yeah. So, remember to have an energy zone in your home and sit in the same place, focus in the same direction. And always remember, it should be towards north, not in north. So according to the, what is that, Indian tradition, or according to the Vedas, we should not head towards the north. Because our earth will be as a magnet. Magnet will have both north and south poles, and we will be having an energy. Similarly, our body also is a magnet. Our body also will be having an energy. Head is a north, toe is a south. So like India map, how the India map would be there. On the top, we will be having a north. On the bottom, we will be having a south. The same thing. Head is a north, bottom is a south. So when both head north and the north is there, it will ripple. The same poles will automatically ripple, right? Just a minute, my charger is gone. So we always need to sit in an opposite direction. That is why we say focus in north, not towards, not placing your head at north. Okay? So it should be in opposite thing. So that is the one thing. And what we do is, in the chakra healing meditation, our body has been divided into a 7 different energy zones. Like how we are having an energy zone in our home. We are building it. We are constructing this energy zone manually. But already our body has been constructed in such a way where we have 7 energy building blocks. These are all the 7 different energy zones. So when and all you get a specific feeling, like Lavanya used to tell, na, so for the feeling, it is in a heart, the heart chakra. That is what the energy. Whenever you get hearted, so that will be hearted in the heart. You'll feel the problem in your heart. So the same thing, everywhere, the voice, Shuddha chakra. So this is in the neck, throat chakra. So the same thing, the vision. The vision is from the third eye, Ajna chakra. So like this, each and every energy point, it has a specific significance. You need to activate it. So to activate that, we are using a different techniques. The first technique is mudras. Why we use mudras is, as we all know, all the fingertips. So our fingertips are connected with the brain nerves. So these are all the energy points or meridian points. These are the powerful points. So just for an example, when you are into a root chakra, okay. So when you are into root chakra, Mooladhara chakra, we call it as a Jnana mudra. So the mudra should be like this. You are touching this. Okay. So you're touching it and place it on your both the palms. When you touch it, this is what called Jnana mudra. So the Jnana means the power of knowledge. So whenever you are into a powerful meditation, the energy will flow from your body. So when you place it like this, the energy, whichever the energy flows from this finger, it will come out and it will again go inside to it. So that we are not allowing any sort of our energy to let go outside. We are bringing all that energy to get inside. Because when you do a meditation, you will double the energy. You will release the doubleized energy. So all the energy will create the bubble around you. So if you create, if you make the chanting is, so we are activating all the five senses, like chanting is speaking. Okay, the mudras are touching, visualizing. We ask you to visualize the colors and listen to the music, listen to the commands. Listening to the commands is nothing but the guided meditation. This is what we always used to say. So by these things, we are activating all your five senses to make you powerful, to release more energy. When you release more energy, your energy bubble, your energy zone will be more activated, more powerful. When your energy is more powerful, actual the cosmic energy will have only the white light. Okay? That is what the power to the entire world. If we are living, can we live without sun? Can we live without sunlight? Even for corona now, all the doctors are suggesting to stay in the light, sunlight for minimum of 1 hour. In spite, even if you have corona or not, doctors are suggesting every day to stay in the sunlight for minimum of 1 hour. That is the power of sunlight. The sunlight is there within your body, in all your seven chakras. When you activate each and every chakra, each and every chakra will release one specific color, starting from head to the root chakra, crown chakra to root chakra. All these seven colors are nothing but Vibhjyar colors: violet, indigo, blue, green, orange, red. All these seven colors connected together. When you are activate all these seven chakras, all these seven together to make a white light. The white light is nothing but a cosmic light. You are generating the cosmic energy. You are becoming almost equal to the power of sun. That is, to reach to that level, it requires a lot of practice. It will not happen within 1 day or within 30 minutes or within 1 week or 1 month. It requires your daily practice with a complete attention, focus, concentration. Remember, if you want to check whether I am doing in a proper way or not, whenever you do a specific chakra exercise, you will feel a vibration in that specific area. If you are not feeling any vibration in that specific area, which means that you need to focus more. That's it. Don't think that you are not doing good. You need more focus. You need more attention. You are doing, you are putting your efforts, but you need more efforts to focus on and tap that every point. So we have only 30 to 40 minutes, where we will be giving you we are introducing you how to activate a specific thing. So actually the thing is that all those things, the feelings, everything, we are just letting you know for your understanding. That's it. But actual, the main intention of this chakra healing meditation is to activate each and every chakra, the position, and release that light, the spark of light. When you open the eyes after the finishing of this thing, when if you can see the spark of light, the white spark around you, which means that you got the energy. And this leads to Kundalini energy also. This can be possible only by the saints, rishis. So don't worry, I'm not doing in a way, I'm not getting all these things. Over a practice only it can be done. And it is, if you are doing it in a proper way, I assure you that no one will get any sort of diseases. No one, nothing can happen. Nothing can beat you. You will be happy from the bottom of the heart, from the outside and inside. You will be healthy physically and mentally. You will be strong, willpower as well as your body power. So everywhere, everywhere, you will become a superpower. So to get that superpower, you need to focus every, each and every bit of yourself. We all know that the body is prepared with the bones, flesh, water, what is that, blood, everything. But that each and every cell is actually made of energy. That energy is nothing but a cosmic energy. We know that after our decimal, our soul will come out. The soul is nothing but your energy. You can control your soul if you can activate each and every chakra. These are nothing but energy blocks. So don't worry. If today one, if you want to activate only one energy block, so practice it, practice it, practice it. It takes a lot of time. Over a practice only you'll get the progress. Remember. Always remember this principle. 1 to the power of 365 is always 1. 1 to the power of 365 is always 1. But 1.01 to the power of 365 is 37.7. If you want to make a note of it, make a note. Or if you want to check in a mobile, cross-check it. So 1 to the power of 365 is 1. 1.01 to the power of 365 is 37.7. So if you target 1% growth, if you try to find, if you want to become 1% growth, you can make it. Practice, practice makes progress. There is no word such as perfection in this world. Nothing is perfect in this world. Everything can be done only through the practice. No one can say perfection. If somebody is saying perfection, it's actually they're lying. There is nothing. Even the quality assurance project, world's most quality assurance project, Six Sigma says there would be only 99.9% of quality. That's it. We cannot assure 100% of quality. So don't say perfect. Don't focus for the perfection. Always focus for the progress. 1% growth. So we are going to activate each and every chakra. We are going to unblock the energy. So we are bringing the sparks. The sparks, it takes a time. And if all the seven colors comes, we are going to generate the cosmic energy. That is how we are going to create the energy bubble. The energy zone makes a huge impact. Whoever comes, we will be more powerful. That is what we always used to say. Now, after looking at him, I'm getting an energy. After looking at them, after looking there, listening to them, I'm getting more power. Which means that their cosmic energy is more powerful. So if you want to be such kind of most influencing personality, most powerful personality, then start practicing your chakra healing meditation. It's one of its kind meditation activity only, but you are bringing the energy. You are generating seven different types of energies. If you want to become a good speaker, if you want to become the best speaker, you should activate your throat chakra. If you want everyone to love you without any, unconditionally, if you want to become the best person, activate your heart chakra. Each and every chakra has its limit. You decide one goal. Yes, this month I want to focus on this chakra. I want to ensure, I want to become the best in this thing. Unless you become a best, you don't go with another thing. Practice it. we are, whatever the time constraint we have, we are giving you, we are equipping you how to get this energy. Don't think that within a 30 minutes, ma'am, sir, I didn't get that energy, I couldn't activate my thing. No, you will not. This is actually an introduction or a basic session. We are introducing you to this topic. We are allowing you to practice it. That's it. You need to sit and practice it with a complete awareness and complete focus and complete concentration. Otherwise, if you wanted to do each chakra every day, we can do that kind of also. It's up to you. But Lavanya, we'll focus only one chakra every day. So,
I think seven chakras, it may be better because every chakra has more energy. I think only seven chakras is better because they have to practice only one chakra for another time. In this time, we have to use the seven chakras, I think.
Exactly.
If they want to practice another time, they can take only one chakra to practice.
So those who want to become a public speaker, they can focus only on throat chakra. Yes, I want to do this thing. So sit in a while and have it. Visualize the color, take the mudra and sit in a proper position and visualize all those things and remember those things. And sometimes if you activated the chakra, you cannot control that energy. You lose that control if you don't have a proper stability. Remember that. You'll be thrown out of your energy zone. This will happen if you are really doing it with a complete awareness and concentration. Sometimes we cannot control ourselves, right? So these are all things will be happen, but this is the most powerful exercise. If you want to become the powerful person with a complete mental health well-beingness, this is one of the best exercise, best meditation, which you can bring the energy out of you and you can see the spark around you wherever you go. Whoever you see, they'll ask you, hey, I see your freshness. You are so active and energetic. It's all because of this energy. So remember, my dear friends, start focusing on those things. And all the seven chakras has the seven significant things. Understand it thoroughly. So we are just giving only intro. Remember again, we are not taking you to the advanced or expert level. We are just introducing you. We are bringing to you. You are there somewhere or we are bringing it to just introduction. The expert and the advanced level is somewhere else. It is to...
And also it's not possible to give all information only in half an hour.
We are not experts.
We know.
Yes. We are not experts, first of all.
Experts.
So we are, being a psychologist, we are introducing you to a new topic where you can improve your mental health well-being through a specific...
And also we are not taking this as a spiritual way, only psychological approach.
Exactly.
That's also.
It's a mixture of, when you say spiritual is a different and religious is a different. This is not a religious thing. It is a spiritual. A spiritual, scientifical, and psychological. A spirit is a soul within you. The soul is nothing but the energy. That energy we are activating. When you say spiritual, so don't take it into a regional. Spiritual is a different from regional. So a spirit is within you, your energy. Whatever you dream, whatever you feel in another world. Every human being will have two spirits. One is a good and another is the other part. So you think now, if you want to purchase a mobile, one side you'll ask, can we buy? No, we don't buy. That is what is spirit. These are all nothing but your thoughts. Your soul is speaking with you. Your inner speaking. This is what we call it as, according to psychology, we call it as auditory digital skill. So you are talking within yourself. What to do now? How to interact now? What I can do? What I can speak? What I can think? This is what called auditory digital, because most of the people, the psychologists also aware of only three things. One is the visual skills, what we see. One is an auditory skill, what we listen. And another one is the kinesthetic skills, what we do. But the fourth one is very, very essential. What we speak ourselves, what we think ourselves, what we feel ourselves. This is nothing but auditory digital. Even the teachers are known only three skills, visual, auditory, and kinesthetic. But this fourth one is very, very essential. This fourth one we are tapping. We are bringing out this energy through enabling this fourth one. And we are using all these three things, visualizing the colors, listening to the, what is that? Guided meditations, commands, and doing the mudras. Mudras plays a crucial role. When you start the mudra, get into the mudra. When you start the chakra, when you say root chakra, directly go to the jnana mudra. So sit into the position and start doing the activity, because root chakra takes a huge time to activate. That is the main root, muladhara. That takes a huge time to activate. Then the next, slowly it will be reduced. And the chanting, the Bija mantra. Bija mantra is nothing but the seed word, the seed letter. Through these letters only, all the letters will come. All our Sanskrit, our script is from, adapted from the Sanskrit. So all these seven are nothing but the Bija mantras. So even the Om is actually a combination of A, U, M, A, U, Ma. So these are the different words. Through these things only we got the all the different letters. So you chant this, while chanting these mantras, from one to another, it will be the frequency you should increase. When you say Mooladhara Chakra, the Bija mantra is Lam. The Lam, the frequency of Lam should be very low. But when you go to the next Swadhisthana, the Swadhisthana Chakra, the Bija mantra is Vam. When you say Lam, next you say Vam with a bit louder voice. Next, Manipura Chakra, the Bija mantra is Ram. Bit louder, Ram. So the frequency varies. This is not the same chakra. The frequency, the chakra, each and every chakra has a different frequency, different energy. So you practice this. So that is the reason why in the first slide itself we have mentioned each and every mantra has a different frequency. So you should not follow the same way how we say Lam, Vam, Sham, Ram, Yam, Ham, Om. So you should say Lam, Sham, Vam, Om. When you say Om, it should be with the high Om. So that is the thing. Okay? So anything else, Lavanya?
Nothing, Mani. Just I want to discuss. Every day we are going to chant, we are going to do meditation. It's nothing going on. Just I want to make a change, because we have to know another one. I feel that to know more, we can earn more.
Exactly.
Like that, we have to introduce more and more. That's what I want.
Right. Don't have any doubts. You are on mute, Gopi-san.
Madam, first we have to practice best. As you mentioned, the seven chakras, we must practice. Then we go next level. We should routinely practice.
That's why, sir, we took only some words and some symptoms. Yes. I said only some content I am saying.
Yes, yes.
For that only, because we had first, to practice only.
When we started the first day, when you saying the crown chakra, my body got vibrated. But another day, it's not happened. First day I got from my navel to head, it's like vibrating using like this mudra. I got vibration. But second, third time, I didn't get this. But I'm waiting for that. When will I get next one?
Definitely, definitely. Go. And, happens with everyone, actually. Yes, Lonnie.
Okay. While we're chanting lum or vum, it can take the vocal cords also. It can get freely. Okay. And the vibrations also different for every bija mantra. If you see, when we're chanting om, the vibrations come from the bottom of the body and head of the top of the head also. Like that, for every bija mantra, there are some different vibrations and some different feel also there. We have to feel that. We have to identify that vibrations. That's very important for this.
And also, as Lavanya rightly pointed out, all the bija mantras should come from the abdomen. It should not come from the throat. So we can speak few words through only the lips, few words only through connecting our tongue with the teeth. So connecting our tongue with our upper chin and lower chin, speaking through the neck, speaking through the throat, speaking through the lungs, and speaking through the abdomen. All these bija mantras should be chanted through abdomen. It should come from the bottom of abdomen, coming from the through the lungs to the throat, neck, and then mouth, coming out from this thing. So then only you'll get the pure energy. So that is very, very essential. Thank you for pointing out, Lavanya. So when you chant it, practice it, how you need to do this thing. They say lum, so it's commonly lum. So we can say normally lum. But when you say from the abdomen, lum, lum. When you do the, whether if you want to check whether you are doing abdomen chanting or not, you can place your hand on your abdomen and check whether your abdomen is increasing and decreasing, like how you are inhaling and exhaling. While chanting, it should move actually. Lum, 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 lum. And the way of sound also will resound in your mind, in your body. It generates a double voice sometimes also when you speak through our lung, abdomen. So you need to do it in a proper way. Yeah. Yeah, Lon.
That's the content I want, Mani.
Anyone have any doubts?
Yes, sir.
Anyone want to ask?
Mani, sir?
Yes, yes, sir.
When we chanting the mantra like lum, ram, yam, we can say it or we can think it as a silent way.
No, we have to say, chant. When I say chant, it should be chant in a proper way.
Yes, sir.
And also, sir, there are some affirmations. Those you have to believe, you have to read with your heart. With your heart.
Okay.
And I want to say to Chandana, because she is a kid from this age, she is using to make all this. It's very good for her.
Exactly. I'm sure she can. Anyone else would like
and
to
one
ask?
Thing, it is very nice, very peaceful. Make use of this chakra meditation with your heart, with your feelings, with your mind entire. Because it's very essential for every human being. Make use of all members in your family. Make use of this. That's what I want to say lastly.
And if you feel you will forget where is your energy zone, you just mark a circle. In the circle, you just make another square. And then in the square, make a triangle. And inside
triangle.
The star, you can write the star. So that in the middle of that star, you can sit actually. So you can mark it in such a way that. So that is one of the powerful way to make it. Because all these shapes has a significance in our chakras. If you can see that each and every chakra design. So you can mark it in your home if you want. Sir, 1 minute left. Anyone ask anything? Anyone want to ask anything? If you don't have anything, we can.
Sir, can I ask the riddle?
We have less than a minute, Chandra. I'm not sure whether we will be in a position to respond.
Okay, let her ask.
Okay. What month of the year has 28 days?
February. Every month has the 28 days, right?
Every month.
Yes, sir.
That's the answer.